They call me Sinister Dave. The paranormal has been part of my life since I was young. Now I seek out some of the most haunted places I can find. Cemeteries. Abandoned insane asylums. Churches. Or even when I'm trying to help others' finances by doing house investigations.
My name is Dave.
I don't always do it alone. Sometimes I do joint investigations with my good friends, Paranormal Tommy from Reality of Ghost.
Hello, I'm Dave from Sinister Paranormal.
We all share a common goal. We seek answers. Who are these spirits?
What's your name?
Evil. Did you hear that?
Evil. Why are they here? Do they have a message for us? Can we help them in any way? This is Sinister Paranormal.
Hi, people. Tom, Reality of Ghost.
Yeah.
And Dave, Sinister Paranormal here.
How you doing, people? We bring it to you.
Alright, yeah.
Without the tree, right? Happy New Year.
Today we're going to turn around and... Oh, wait, wrong. Today we're going to turn around and wish you guys a Happy New Year, have some brewskis, and also...
And take four.
Okay. Happy New Year, everybody.
And a Merry Crystal Meth, a miss.
Yeah, whatever he said. So, anyway, we're going to turn around and try to...
Where are we turning around from?
I don't know. But as long as we turn around and get the outside people to know that... What are you drinking it for? We are lush.
That's to us.
All right.
Chest, people.
Oh, God, I don't want hair on my chest.
That's some special Puerto Rican rum right
later,
there.
That's because I didn't eat.
Don't throw it up on me.
That just makes your hair stand up on ends, man.
You probably can't sit down right now. Oh, Wilbur.
Anyway, now that we drink gasoline.
Yeah.
Today is an introduction on Tech Talk. This is going to be show 64 for me, and...
I don't even number them.
Oh, he lost track in what, 100
can't
or something?
Count.
Yeah, so we're all, yeah. Anyway, let's all get that going on over there. All right, well, here's to me and everybody else.
But anyway.
Do you have anything that you want to discuss on any type of equipment that we use and to get the...
We have all kinds of equipment.
Okay, what do you want to start out with, Dave?
Well, obviously we can't show you the cameras we're using right now.
Okay.
You can tell them what kind of camera you have.
Oh, sure we can. We can show you the type of pictures, cameras that we're using. Tom's always thinking.
Dave's always drinking.
One or the other. Oh. Here's the type of cameras that we're using, people. Watch. These are the type of cameras that we're using.
What kind of camera is it?
Okay, well, they're both Sonys. Mine's a little older of a model with a fisheye lens. which gets all angle. And Dave's is a new modernized feature with an extra wider lens than mine. That's why I need the bubble fisheye there to make that situation just solid.
We both use Sony hard drive cameras, yep. No discs, no cards. Oh, did yours use a card?
Mine uses a 30 gig internal hard drive. Mine doesn't have a card. Does yours have a card?
Yeah, I could use the card or the hard drive.
Mine has a memory stick. I have an 80 gig memory stick in the top. But I also have a 30 gig internal hard drive.
But they're both night vision.
They're both night vision, night shot, face detection, picture plus. We also have IR, infrared.
And the IR blaster right there that I made.
Yep. Dave conjured up a nice little recipe for infrared. And
you got a lot more equipment than I do. Why don't you show the people?
All right. Well, okay. All right, to start out with people, we have Morse code, SOS, walkie-talkies that if we are in different rooms or buildings, we can contact each other and just do some beeps, which is very quick, instead of talking, like a certain amount of beeps, like, look, it's an emergency, why don't you get here quick, so we'll do one beep. We'll do two beeps if everything's all right, but we heard something. And three, if we just want to know if the other guy's all right, he'll just beep it three times. But anyway, very cheap, inexpensive, 9-volt battery operated. We also have our little mini mag lights, which are... we can turn on to a certain aspect, a certain certain potential, and
start the bigger one.
Yeah, and they also we turn it on just so it's lit and just so it's ready to go out. So if the energy comes across, it's either going to make the rubber on the O-ring either expand or stay the way it is.
Contract.
Yeah, contract. But I don't want to go that far, but.
There's a way to communicate and get responses from entities, spirits, ghosts, whatever you want to call them.
And they really work.
Absolutely.
We also have, testers.
K2 meters.
K2 meters. And we installed little tiny speakers so that way we can hear the sound also when it's going off.
In case you're not paying attention, you can hear the noise going off.
And it makes you turn right around and you can see it and see how much, what is it, magnetic fields or in the air?
EMF.
EMFs, electronic magnetic fields.
Digital voice recorder.
Yep. Oh, those kids are pretty loud. And we also have, the cheap little cameras that, we can whip out any time that our main cameras go bad, as far as battery power.
Just got a new piece of equipment here. This is a Canon picture camera. Kind of a little high tech, get better pictures.
Same similar camera, just smaller, digital form. Lens comes out automatically. Same memory full because I took the card out. But this one takes video also. It's a GE. I don't know what his is. What is yours?
Canon.
Oh, it's a Canon. Canon's a very good camera, by the way, very expensive.
And of course, something that every ghost investigator has to have, the ghost box.
Conversions from transistor radios to 4 channels per second. Anything that's speaking in a continuous loop of 4 channels per second, you got yourself an entity, people. Definitely an entity.
They can manipulate the sounds of voices on these recorders. And,
also the living.
We can manipulate it.
And here's
an electro sensor,
which basically does the same thing as the K2 meter.
Yeah.
This picks up electronic magnetic fields also. In other words, see? You can put the phone near it to prove that it works.
So that'll work on a K2 meter too?
It should. See? So don't try to make a call, people, because we will debunk your videos. So if you're making a call and that K2 meter goes off, you know that we're on to you. We're always watching.
You're on an investigation. Leave your cell phones in the car.
Right. Because we're always watching. Oh. I have to turn around and also mention that we have other cameras, pocket cameras. This one also is a Memorex. You get these cheap for like 13, 14 bucks. Then again, it's another backup camera. Not only that, we have another camera. Face detection, everything, etc. You turn around and move the screen, see it front, back. Vivitar, $12.95 with SD card slot inside.
What is that, a Walmart?
Walmart. It's a DVR 410. These things are actually beautiful. We also have infrared flashlights. Now, you can't buy these people. You have to make these on your own.
You gotta make them. You gotta make your own ghost.
You gotta make everything.
You can buy it on eBay for an exorbitant amount of money.
Right, or you can make them your own. Yeah. You can go to Radio Shack, get yourself some IR bulbs, take your regular flashlight, unscrew it, take the bulbs out with a soldering gun, heat them up till the bulbs pop out, then put the IR bulbs in, heat them up again, and they'll solder them in place. Now, these are only visualized by a camera or by a video camera.
It has IR
and
capability.
Believe me, you also have EMF pumps. This makes a spirit, entity, soul, anything that has electronic magnetic fields draw to it. And it works. See, people? So, now that they approved that five times, we have
they
to
may
put...
may not have got it the first time.
We have to put into aspect that everything that we use is used in all seriousness. And believe me, people, I'm a straight, blunt shooter. Not only that, Dave has something to say.
I don't know what it is, but I'll figure it out. I don't know.
Say anything you want to say, Sinister. Guy looks better than Sinister Gates, don't you think?
We bring it to you.
Yep, we bring it to you.
Without the tray.
Without the tray. Hopefully we don't eat it before we get it to you.
Now remember, we do this on a limited budget of zero.
Yes, of zero, nothing. We absolutely do these shows for free. We don't make any money off them.
We don't have any big camera crews following us around. We do this with our own equipment that we pay for.
That's right. Exactly. Right. I'm glad that he summed that up in a nutshell. Well, here's to you, buddy.
Don't smash my bed.
The clang of happiness right there.
That's the sound of joy.
And on those really, really, really bad nights, people, that we can't see a thing, we break out our 1939 lantern.
That's the year my mother was born.
Oh, yeah.
1939.
Wow. And these things, they let off a tremendous amount of light. I mean...
And it's a good trigger object.
Oh, no kidding, because it's just a source. Everybody concentrates on the lantern. And then before you know it, you're seeing things moving, you're seeing things floating, falling, noises. I mean, it's unbelievable, people.
You may have seen that in our videos, Nine Man's Misery.
Oh, yeah. You have a pretty good amount of footage on that show. Now, before you leave, people, to go do an investigation, don't leave without your flashlights. Now, look at all them flashlights in there, people. There you go. You got to have an extra or maybe one or two free at all times.
We live in Rhode Island, the smallest state in the United States, so you could probably light up a small town with that thing.
Oh, yeah, because just remember, you could get locked in somewhere, and you're going to need light to try to get out.
Or you can go into an abandoned insane asylum and get lost.
That's right. Wait a minute. You know how many chicks told me to get lost?
Yeah.
You're like, yeah.
They said to get bent. I told them, bent over. I think I know you.
Like a 1950 Cadillac Pimp DeVille?
Snoop DeVille.
Snoop DeVille. Well, anyway, people, Tech Talk, Do you have your show on right now, your radio show?
Yeah.
Is it on at this time?
Not this time, but it'll be on at another time.
Why don't you give them a time when your radio show's on? He has a paranormal radio show.
If you're a paranormal group or you want to get your name out there, just send me an email. Right there.
Right there at the bottom of the screen. Sinister
Paranormal.
Sinister
Paranormal Radio Show on Blog Talk Radio. You could be on live.
That's right. And here's my email and address across the bottom in case you want to go on an investigation. Or you can turn around and call up Sinister and he'll turn
just
around.
Not collect.
Yep. I'm from realityofghost.com. At realityofghost@gmail.com. And he is at
sinisterparanormal.com.
There you go.
At Gmail.
There you go.
So anyway.
Sinister here. Knew him for years. You gotta understand him to love the guy. He's alright.
Don't love me.
No problem with him.
Don't come to my funeral.
There you go. Don't anybody show up unless you got a keg.